Well, people look at this from different angles. Some people say it was just happenstance, dumb luck. Other people would say that you happened to see something and your mind clicked. And other people, including myself, would say there's something greater behind all of this. Actually, I think it's all three.
Homer came home. He'd heard about this type of food rescue program.
Susan Goodell, who was the head of Forgotten Harvest in Detroit, one of the largest food rescue operations in the U.S., was making a presentation. Afterwards, I went up to Susan and I said, "Do you think that could work in a rural area?" And she said, "I don't know why not, and I'll give you all the help you need."
Well, many people thought we were crazy. Homer saw what we were doing and said, "We can feed our people if we can bring this model to northern Michigan."
I have a good friend, George Powell, who is in the food business.
Homer gave us a call, my brother and I, back I think in 2007, and he had an idea and he wanted to share it with us.
And he got excited. Well, Becky was already excited. And then Bruce Byl became a part of the group.
A team was formed, somewhat of an informal board.
Cecil McNally. He said, "We can do it through Goodwill."
It was really the first time that fresh food of any significance was introduced into the whole pantry chain throughout the five counties. It helped us change the philosophy of how we provided meals at the Goodwill Inn. We went from processed food to doing most of what we were preparing as fresh food.
I don't know how we would have progressed if Goodwill, Cecil and Goodwill, hadn't stepped in, gave us an office, gave us all the in-kind stuff. You know, telephone,
a building,
help from their
kitchen.
Staff, everything. Marty Watts from Olson's said, "I'm in." And Sandy from Oriana was there. And she said, "And Oriana you can use as a beginning." I told the church we were going to do something really big. They were very excited and were willing to do whatever we needed. And I said, "Well, we're going to need money." And so immediately they came up with $50,000. Now others joined in because we wanted at least a year, maybe 2 years of operating money before we began. The church still continues to be one of our biggest supporters, and I'm very proud of that.
We took a field trip to Detroit down to Forgotten Harvest so they could teach us the concept, the program, the processes. That happened to coincide with a huge power outage due to a storm that rolled through there. So we got to see firsthand, somewhat in an emergency situation, how they would rescue food.
And while we were there, because of that storm, three or four trucks came in full of this stuff, and we were putting it everywhere. People were stuffing it underneath tables, bread, you know, just an amazing amount of food. And I turned to the lady and I said, "And how are you going to get, you know, how long are you going to take to get rid of this? And what are you going to do with all this food?" And she said, "I'll put a sign on the street that says free food and it'll be gone in 30 minutes. Gave us so much energy to come back up here and get it done.
We knew then that it would not be difficult to sell this program.
We started out, I think the first year, that was 2008. And I believe we picked up about 300,000 pounds.
And that was so exciting. Well, now, get millions of pounds.
It's evolved into something so much greater. We're working with farmers, the Food Coalition, the groundwork.
We try to make it as easy for the food donors to give us the good food. The pantries need the food. We're giving it to them. We're raising money to do it. That makes it exciting. But there's no downside to this.
Making use of food that would be thrown away. It wasn't costing them anything. This was all for free.
Where typically it would go to their dumpster and then it would go to landfill, they now were not going to have those expenses.
It was a success. It was a needed program. It helped fill a hole in the community.
We're keeping it out of the landfill and we're helping people at the same time.
This was a total win-win for everybody.
When you see that things are a part of people's soul or heart, you know they're going to work.